Well, one person who knows just how scary those judges can be is the former X Factor contestant Amelia Lilly.
Hello.
Bring back memories. Does it bring back
it
memories?
It does, yeah. I'm like watching that and I'm just like, oh my God.
Nerves about when you were just about to go on.
Yeah, definitely.
We're going to talk to you a lot more about how it's all going in just a moment.
First, a quick last look at what's happening where you are.
We have been talking about The X Factor this morning. It's back this weekend. We have a former contestant with us, Amelia Lilly, who knows exactly what it's like to go through those nerve-wracking auditions.
Yes, Amelia Lilly was the show's comeback kid 3 years ago when she was knocked out by a mentor and then voted back into the competition by the public.
She eventually came third, and three hit singles later, she's now releasing her debut album. Welcome.
Hello.
Good to see you.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you very much for coming in. Your new single is California.
It is, yeah.
We can have a listen to that, I think.
Yay.
Let's have a listen. Laying here, feeling so rough. Guess the pink bubbles didn't do enough to cover up
the way I feel. What's the point in wearing these heels? A waterbed at any point during the making of that video?
That was...
Because you were fully dressed.
That was a mission and a half to try and get on that and stay dry.
Someone have to push you out really gradually from the side?
Yeah, but luckily, the dress I was actually wearing, it was a really nice dress. It was a Ted Baker dress, but it was made of scuba material.
Ah.
So even though I was soaking wet, you couldn't even tell.
So you had fallen in.
Oh my! Well, I was absolutely drenched, because when you get onto a Lilo, the water automatically comes into the Lilo. Yeah. So I was absolutely soaking, but because the dress was made of scuba, you couldn't tell, so it was brilliant.
The secrets of video and pop videos.
Fantastic.
3 years on.
Yeah.
Where are you? Are you where you thought you could be? Because you'd always have hoped to be here, wouldn't you?
Do you know what? It's been what an experience, and what an amazing experience as well. I feel as though I've really, really grown up in the past 3 years. All good, of course. But I think, you know, I've had three singles out. I've got a brand new record label now, you know, a brand new record deal. And the fact that I've been able to write my own songs this time is just... It feels really fresh for me and really nice. So, you know, because I started writing when I was only 12. So when I got into The X Factor, that kind of stopped, obviously, because I was so hectic. So to be able to go back in the studio and write myself now, it's just amazing. So I feel really excited to be coming back with a brand new single that I've written myself.
I'm sort of sensing from the way you're characterising it that you're sort of drawing... There's a bit of a line being drawn between The X Factor part of your career, which is clearly hugely important, the reason you got your break in the first place, and kind of where you are now, where you're going.
Do you know what? I will always look back at my X Factor experience as an amazing time. I've got no regrets. I feel as though it's given me a fantastic platform, opened so many doors for me. But it does feel like a long time ago now.
Well, we can look back and you can see
I'm
just
really
how, have a look. This here, it's almost like this is your life. Here you go.
I'm Amelia Lilly. I'm 16.
Chuckling all the way through there.
I was.
What do you think of the audition?
My makeup's dreadful. Oh, it's dreadful. What was I doing? No, but it's all part of growing up, isn't it? So, yeah.
Kelly Rowland was your mentor.
Yes, she was.
What was she like?
Do you know, I still have to pinch myself to this day, the fact that I even got to perform with her, like, on the live final, and what an inspiring woman she is, truly. I mean, the final week of The X Factor, I spent with her every single night, just one-to-one with her. And, like, we were stood in, like, the disabled toilet together, like, praying, and I had, like, that moment with Kelly that I'll never, ever forget for the rest of my life. She's just such an incredible woman.
Yeah. Why were you in the disabled toilet?
Well, because I was nervous and I was going on to perform, and she was like, say a prayer. Yeah, it was the only toilet around, so we were just stood in there praying together, and that was a moment that I'll always keep in here for the rest of my life.
So you're 16 years old when the audition took place.
Yeah.
You had a big old voice on you.
Thanks.
At such a young age. I mean, who had you sung to before that point?
Do you know what's really funny is when I was really young, I was super shy. And the first time I ever sung to an audience was when I was 9 years old. And I remember just shaking on the stage. And I kind of grew up loving musical theatre, and that's how where I see myself is going into musical theatre. So I'd always liked being on a stage performing and acting. And then my dad kind of encouraged me to do The X Factor. So performing in that arena on The X Factor audition was a massive step for me because I was super nervous. You know, there was like 5,000 people there, so that was a big crowd.
16 years old when you did that audition. And I think one of the judges, correct me if I'm wrong, I think Cheryl Cole said to one 16-year-old, you should actually be in school. It's tough. It's a tough business. Get yourself grounded before you go in there. Yeah. Do you agree with that?
I think it depends on what type of person you are. I think you've got to be, I think you've definitely got to be strong to get through it, and also prepare yourself mentally for it as well, because it is draining, it is tiring, but if you know what you want to do from being a very young age, which is what I knew I wanted to be a singer from a very young age, and I just worked my absolute hardest to, you know, to do well on the show, and I have no regrets. I think it all depends on how much you want it.
I saw your mum and dad there watching.
I did.
Are they still supporting you?
They are. They're probably watching right now. Hi, mum and dad.
Your lifestyle presumably has changed in many ways.
Yeah.
Do you now, people sometimes conjure an image of a kind of a pop star, rock star lifestyle?
Do
you live that? Is that your life? Are you living quite a kind of wild lifestyle?
Not particularly. I like my sleep, you know. I mean, my voice is my tool at the end of the day, and I need my sleep. But I really like just having free time and spending it with my dogs, you know. I really like free time just to spend with my family. I like to go home as well. I love going up north to see my family. So, I don't know, I'm not so much of a rock star. I don't really like to go out partying too much. So, I like to, you know, get my rest.
You set an example now, though, to people as well.
Absolutely.
I mean, you have a role to play for young children who are looking up to you. You've seen your story and think I can do that. And where do I go? What does it mean?
Absolutely. I think that, you know, when you do come into this industry, I think it's entirely up to you if you want to be a role model or not. And I definitely want to be a role model. And, you know, I've for people who don't know out there, I've got type 1 diabetes. And over the past 3 years, I've got letters from parents saying, you've inspired my children to, you know, believe that they can go on and achieve, you know, to what they want to be in life and be successful. And that for me is like, it really touches me here because I think, you know, I've had the condition since I was 3 and a half, but I've never let it affect me in any way. And I still do the job that I've always wanted to have. So it's really nice.
Really nice having you here today. Isn't my imagination of Simon Cowell wearing his trousers a little lower? You were there 3 years ago. What do you think?
I didn't actually meet him. I didn't meet him because he was in the USA.
Yeah.
So I was the year that Gary and
Do you
Kelly
think he's going to make a difference? There. Having him
definitely.
Here.
He's the boss. He's the big man.
He's the boss.
Yeah.
Amelia, good luck with everything.
Thank you very much.
Good
Thanks
to see
for having
you.
Us. Thank you.
Amelia Lilly's new single is called California. Well, that's it from us this morning.
We're back tomorrow from 6 o'clock.
We're talking to the Mad Men actor, John Hamm. I've been talking to him about life as Don Draper. See what he had to say tomorrow.
Bye-bye.
Have a good day.